And over 56,000 learners will have no schools to report back to come Monday next week, after it emerged that 339 private schools have permanently shut down. Now, the Kenya Private Schools Association has revealed that over 1,000 teaching and non-teaching staff have been rendered jobless owing to the impact of COVID-19 on learning institutions. And with the pressure expected to shift to public school education, Education Cabinet Secretary George Magoha has asked school heads to use tree shades as classrooms so as to achieve social distancing. Nimrod Tabu reports.
Only 4 days remain before schools finally reopen fully in the country after being closed for close to 9 months following the COVID-19 outbreak. For many learners in the country, this appears to be an exciting moment. But for proprietors, school heads, parents and learners from 339 private schools, there is nothing to cheer about. According to the Kenya Private Schools Association, 339 private schools have shut permanently owing to cost burden occasioned by the COVID-19 pandemic. Consequently, over 56,000 learners will be affected and could be forced to seek places in public schools that are either fully occupied or are struggling to comply with safety protocols laid out by the Ministry of Health and the Ministry of Education.
The class teacher,
including having lesser children per class to ensure social distancing.
We have a lot of challenges as private schools. One of them is the issue of finances to support putting up of the necessary protocols to enable a smooth reopening of schools.
Failure by the 339 institutions to reopen also means that 1,247 teachers and workers in these private schools have been rendered jobless. The association is also demanding that the government releases to schools the 7 billion shillings stimulus package it had pledged to private schools in order to cushion them against the adverse effects.
We had been promised 7 billion shillings by the government, which has not come to date, which has meant that private schools have to look for very expensive credit facilities from the commercial sources. And this is going to make the cost of education, especially at this point in time when we are sorting out the issues of COVID, to become expensive. And this cost, of course, will have to be transferred to the parents.
Even as thousands of parents and pupils brace for the difficult task of seeking places in public schools, proprietors of two private schools that had been converted into poultry business are struggling to revive. Pastor Joseph Maina is the proprietor of Mwea Brethren School in Kirinyaga. After the pandemic was reported in the country, he shut down the school and decided to keep poultry as a means to stay afloat. He turned several classrooms into poultry houses and began selling chicken as a means to raise funds to pay his teachers.
Safari ya kufunga kuku haikuwa rahisi sana kwa sababu niliingia katika kazi ambao mimi si biashara ambao sijazoea na sijaifanya maishani yangu yote.
The venture paid off, but it is now time to prepare for reopening. We caught up with Maina transferring his chicken to another location. He's making plans to ensure that pupils will return and continue learning. Maina says both the closure of schools early this year and poultry keeping have taught him valid lessons.
Kama hata ningekaa hivyo, hata kukaa bila kazi, ni hata mimi mwenyewe ningekuwa na ugonjwa labda hata uwe wa COVID-19. Kwa sababu nimekuwa mtu ambaye ni mbize sana, sikupata hata kusijua kama COVID ilikuweko.
At Ndima Kanini Academy in Karatina, Nyeri, back to school preparations are ongoing. Painters are carrying out last-minute touches. Like Pastor Maina in Kirinyaga, the director, Lincoln Jogu, several months ago used some of the classrooms to keep chicken. At the time, it looked as though the school would never reopen. Panjogu says the school is rising up and has even constructed 11 additional classes. CCTV cameras have also been mounted in order to monitor children while learning. The school has also drilled a borehole to boost water supply. Meanwhile, the Education Cabinet Secretary, Professor George Magoha, has admitted that there will be a challenge to attain social distancing in schools, but he wants teachers to ignore politicians who are playing down efforts to reopen the schools.
There is no country in the world where new classrooms have been built because of the COVID-19 pandemic. I want to plead with our gallant teachers to ensure that they become innovative. For example, in this school, you can see in between the trees, if the weather is as good as it is now, nothing stops the head teacher, who is an excellent teacher, from having classes outside there, in addition to others being inside the room.
He also urged teachers to allow all children back to school, regardless of whether parents can afford to pay fees immediately or later. Nimrod Tabu, Citizen TV.